Hello students, so today we will discuss about Fourier series. Now any function fx, say periodic and piecewise continuous function can be expressed as in terms of Fourier series, which is looks like something like this: k0 plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx. Plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx. This is a Fourier series where a0 is 1/2 pi minus pi to pi fx dx. An is equal to 1/2 pi minus pi to pi fx cos nx dx, and bn is equal to 1/2 pi minus pi to pi fx sin nx dx. Now, to represent fx in a Fourier series, there are certain conditions, and those conditions are called Dirichlet's condition. According to Dirichlet's conditions, the function must have a finite number of maximum and minimum. And the second condition is that the function must have a finite number of finite discontinuities in a period of one oscillation. So function should have a finite number of finite discontinuities in a period of one oscillations. So these are the two conditions which must be satisfied by a function to be expressed in terms of a Fourier series. Now, there are certain cases in the Fourier series. So, if the function fx is an even function, for even function it means f minus x is equal to fx. In that case, the term a0, which is expressed as 1 by 2 pi minus pi fx dx, it changes to 1 by pi 0 to pi fx dx, and the term an for an even function is 2 by pi 0 to pi fx cos nx dx, and bn is equal to 0. So these are the three constants that we require to find out for any form of even function. So for an even function, the Fourier series looks fx is equal to a0 plus summation over n a n cos nx. Now the case 2 is when fx is odd. By odd means f minus x is equal to minus fx. If this is the case, then here both a0 and an are equal to 0, and the only term that remains is bn. That 2 bn is now 2 by pi 0 to pi fx sin nx dx. So the second aspect of a Fourier series is when there is a change in interval takes place. So there is a change in interval, change of interval. That means from minus pi to, it has been changed to say some arbitrary minus L to L. Then what should the Fourier series look like? So first of all, if this equation, the first thing that one should understand is that the term n x will now be n pi x by n. So based upon this change, the Fourier series will also change, also look different. So for this case, the Fourier series fx is is equal to V0 plus summation VN plus summation N is equal to 1 to infinity cos N by X by L plus N is equal to 1 to infinity AN here, should be on AN, AN, and BN sine N by X by L. This is how the Fourier series will look like, and so the constants will also change accordingly. A0 will now be equal to 1 by 2L. Minus L to L fx dx then A n v equal to 1 by pi minus L to L fx cos n pi x by L dx and V n will be equal to 1 by L minus L to L fx sine n by x by L into dx. So this is how the Fourier series will look like. Now if we consider half the interval, that means if we consider instead of minus L to L, if we are considering interval between 0 to L, then how the Fourier series will look like. And so in that case the cosine series, that is fx will be an even function, so fx will be equal to 0 plus n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos n by x by L. if xv is an even function of x, and then the same interval, if x is an even function, oh sorry, this is an odd function, then simply as in the previous cases, if x is simply written as summation n bn sine f x by n. Where bn is equal to 2 by l 0 to l fx sine n phi x by l fx sine n phi x by l. So this is how the Fourier series will look like if x is an odd and its range is half. So this is the first case and this is the second case. Now the Fourier series can also be expressed in complex form. So complex form of Fourier series. So here fx is simply written as equal to n is equal to minus infinity to infinity c to the power n e to the power I n x, where c n is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity f x e to the power minus I n x dx. Next aspect is if the Fourier series is in the interval 0 to t and the period is also t. Period is also t. So how to express in that case? So like in the first cases, so we have already done it for 0 to l, so it will be the same thing. So we can write the Fourier series fx as, or let's say it's ft, and it is equal to a0 plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos phi omega t, an cos n omega t, an cos n omega t plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sine n omega t. And the constants for a0 an and bn will be similar to that we have obtained for the case of 0l, only the t will be replaced by n. Now coming to an important identity in a Fourier series, it's called Parseval's identity. So what is the possible that will be fx square is equal to e a0 square plus 1 by 2 summation a n square plus b n square. Here fx is equal to summation n minus infinity to plus infinity cn e to the power I n by x by n. So if somebody finds out, has to find out the mod of this value square, so it will be equal to the average value of fx whole square, and it will be equal to summation n minus infinity to infinity cn square.